and Museo Guadalupe Aztlán for a great exhibit with Chicano newspapers from the 70s. I was a part of the Chicano movement, Brown Beret, Raza Unida Party. You won't know that from being National President Lulac, but I tell you what, we've come a long way. And these stories bring back a lot of memories, and it's important that we preserve our history, our culture, la lucha of the resistencia, and of our struggle to make sure that every Latino, Latina, Chicano or Chicana, civil rights are protected and taken care of, and that we elect a Latino or Latina as President of the United States, as Mayor of Houston, as Governor of Texas. Viva la raza.
And una pregunta, President Garcia. Tell us just in brief how you want to support a future multi-million dollar Mexican-American Chicano Latino museum.
Yeah. San Antonio and Dallas both have Latino museums and cultural centers. Houston is the largest city in Texas, the largest Latino population in Texas. And we don't have a Latino cultural museum and center here. I think it's time that we organize, we demand in the next bond election that at least $20 million be set aside for a Latino cultural center in Houston that will also preserve not only the history of Latinos, but also the culture, nuestra cultura, from La Quincinera to the Mariachis to the Chicano movement in Moody Park, where I was when Joe Campos Torres got killed by the police, till today, and the movements for making our LULAC 60 house on Bagby a national and state historical place. All of these can be done, but we need to unite and we need to fight for this important part of our culture.
Muchas gracias, Presidente.